this tutorial, we'll show you how to configure foreign exchange rate overrides for net income before tax and country-by-country Table 1 accounts in Oracle Tax Reporting Cloud. Let's start by looking at how to configure rate overrides for the net income before tax accounts used in the current provision, the consolidated effective tax rate, and the statutory effective tax rate. By default, these accounts are translated using the current period exchange rate. You may need to override the default rate with a blended rate. The net income before tax accounts are translated using the override rate, and the difference between the account values translated at the override rate and at the default rate is posted as a permanent difference. To configure exchange rate overrides for net income before tax, you edit the member properties for the base level accounts under the TRCS_NIBT adjusted member in the tax accounts hierarchy. In the NIBT FX rate override account column, select the rate account to use for translating the account. A system-defined rate account named TRCS_NIBT override is provided. If you need additional rate accounts, you can add them to the NIBT override rate accounts parent in the exchange rates hierarchy. In the NIBT override difference account column, select a permanent difference account. I'll select PermGS0003, which is the foreign exchange permanent difference account. The difference account stores the difference between the account value translated at the override rate and the default rate. After modifying the account properties, remember to refresh the database to apply your changes. To enter override rates for net income before tax accounts, use the NIBT FX rates override form. This form has rows for all the rate accounts under the NIBT override rate accounts parent in the exchange rates hierarchy. In the POV, select the entity for which to enter rates. You enter rates to translate from the base currency of the entity in the POV to the currencies in the rows. You cannot enter amount overrides. You don't need to run the compute rates rule after entering rates. If during translation no NIBT override rate is found, the current period exchange rate for the entity is used, or the global assumption rate if no entity rate exists. NIBT override rates are stored in the console cube. So if you're loading rates from a file or using data management, you should make the console cube your target. You can also enter override rates for translating your Table 1 accounts for country-by-country reporting. You enter override rates for country-by-country reporting using the FX Rates Override CbCR form. Select the entity for which to enter rates and the currency for the rates in the POV. All Table 1 accounts automatically display as rows in the form. You do not need to configure member properties. However, when you add new accounts for Table 1, you must refresh the database before you can enter rates for the new accounts. For each account, enter a rate to translate from the base currency of the POV entity to the POV currency. You don't need to run the compute rates rule after entering rates. If during translation no CbCR override rate is found, the current period exchange rate for the entity is used, or the global assumption rate if no entity rate exists. For the profit loss before income tax entry account, if no override rate is found, the NIBT override FX rate is used if defined in the provision. Rates for CbCR overrides are stored in the CbCR cube, so if you're loading rates from a file or using data management, you should make the CbCR cube your target. In this tutorial, we showed you how to configure foreign exchange rate overrides for net income before tax and country-by-country Table 1 accounts in Oracle Tax Reporting Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.